Hello everyone, myself Professor P.G.Chitte, working in Mechanical Engineering Department, WIT Solapur. Today we will discuss the classes, objects and method, part 2. The learning outcomes are, students will be able to explain concepts regarding classes, objects and methods. Also, the students will be able to develop Java source codes with the help of applications of classes, objects and methods. The contents are, first, we will discuss the recap of first session, and after that, we will take the program based on the applications of classes, objects, and methods. Now, we will see the two methods that we have discussed in the session one, getData method and rectArea method, which consist of the declaration of the variables. So, parameter list means the variables, which consist of the type void, the method name as a getData, where the length and width are the variables. The method to consist of the rectArea method, which consists of the formula for area of the rectangle. And after that, we are returning that value which will be stored in the rectArea method. After combining the method 1 and method 2, so the getData method consists of the declaration of the variables, and rectArea method consists of the declaration of the area of rectangle. Object declaration. Object declaration consists of the declaration of the particular object, and after that the initialization. These are the two steps where rectangle will be the class name, rect1 will be the object name, and where new will be the constructor or the parameter which will combine the class name rectangle and the rect1 object name. So combining 1 and 2, we will get the rectangle rect1 and is equal to new rectangle, where rectangle is an class name, rect1 is an object name, new is an constructor, and again rectangle is an class name. Similarly for rectangle 2, rectangle rect2 is equal to new rectangle, where rect1 and rect2 are the object names for the rectangle 1 and rectangle 2. The next part is accessing the class members. So accessing the class members means providing the value for the variable. So this will be the first method, where object name dot variable name is equal to value. This will be the general code for the to declare the value for the variable. For example, for rectangle 1, so rect1 dot length is equal to 15 and rect1 dot width is equal to 47, where rect1 is an object name, length and width are the variables, and 15 and 47 are the values for length and width. Here we are calculating the area for the rectangle 1, where int capital A1 is equal to rect1 dot length into rect1 dot width, where we are having the variables called as rect1 dot length into rect1 dot width. Second method. So here we are recalling the two methods that we have declared already, that is getData method and rectArea method. GetData method consists of the declaration of the variables. Now, in general code, object name dot method name in the bracket parameter list. Here the parameter list consists of the values for the variables. So rect2 is an object name for the second rectangle, dot getData is an object, the method name, and 30 and 60 are the values for the variables. Here 30 will be for x, 60 will be for y, but we have declared that x is equal to length and y is equal to width, means 30 is equal to length and 60 is equal to width. Second method, here we have to recall the rectArea method. So directly we can store that value, particular value, that is area for the rectangle 2, in the A2 variable. So int A2 is equal to rect2 dot rectArea, where rect2 is an object name for the second rectangle. RectArea is a method we have declared already. So values will be stored in the length and width, and the calculation of the area for the rectangle 2 will be stored in the particular A2. Now think how to declare the object and method that we have discussed. Now we will move to the program. The program statement. Write a program to calculate areas for the two rectangles with the applications of classes, objects and methods. Now we will go to the program. Now we will go step by step. Here we have declared the class rectangle and class area. What class rectangle consists of? The class rectangle consists of declaration of the variables and declaration of the area for the rectangle. The class area will be called as a main class because it consists of the main statement, that is public static void main string args. So whenever we want to execute the program, we have to use the main class. Now, so class rectangle, length and width are the variables, integer as a data type. After that, void get data in the bracket int x and int y, where void is a type, get data is a method, int x and int y are the parameter list. After that, we are declaring x is equal to length and y is equal to width. Now, so get data method consists of declaration of the variables. Here we are not declaring any values for the length and width. We are declaring the value for the variable that is also called as accessing the class member in the main class, that is area. After that, now we have to provide the value for the variable, and after that the areas for the rectangle. Now we are declaring the area for the rectangle in the rect area. So int a is equal to length into width. So where integer as a data type, rect area is a method name, and we are storing the formula for the rectangle in the rect area method. Here the problem statement is that we have to calculate the areas for the two rectangles, but here we had stored the formula for the area of rectangle, that is once, means we have to recall the rect area method twice. And after that, whenever the value will be stored in the return, we are returning the value in the rect area method. Now, we are moving towards the main class, that is class area, which consists of public static void main string args statement. Integer a1 and a2. So a1 and a2 are the output variables where we are storing the areas of rectangles in the a1 and a2. Now, these two statements are the object declaration statements. So rectangle rect1 is equal to new rectangle, where rect1 is an object name, rectangle is a main class, and new is a constructor, and rectangle again the main class. So rectangle rect1 is a declaration statement. Rect1 is equal to new rectangle is an initialization statement. So by combining initialization and declaration statement, we will get the statement like rectangle rect1 is equal to new rectangle, where object name rect1 will be for the rectangle 1. Similarly for rectangle 2, rectangle rect2 is equal to new rectangle, where rect1 and rect2 are the object name for the rectangle 1 and rectangle 2. Now, these three statements are for areas for the first rectangle. Now, first method, so we have to declare the values for the variable. So we have declared the rect1 as an object name, dot length is an variable is equal to value. So rect1 dot length is equal to 15. So this will be the value for the variable length. Similarly, rect1 dot width is equal to 30, where rect1 is an object name, variable is an width, and 30 is the value. So the formula will be a1 is equal to rect1 dot length and rect1 dot width. So this will be the area for rectangle 1, and that will be stored in the a1. Now, area for the second rectangle. Area for the second rectangle. So here we are recalling the get data method and the rect area method. Now, so rect2 is an object name for the second rectangle. Get data is a method name which consists of the variable declaration, and 40 and 50 are the values for the variable, where x is equal to 40 and y is equal to 50, but we have declared that x is equal to length and y is equal to width, means length is equal to 40 and width is equal to 50. Now the values for the variable we have declared. Now a2 is equal to rect2 dot rect area. Rect2 is an object name, rect area, that we have declared already the method, which consists of area for the rectangle. So 40 into 50, that will be the length into width, and that value will be stored in the rect area. Now system.out.println area1 is equal to plus a1. Already we have stored the values of a1 and a2. So with the help of these two statements, we can store the values. So area1 is equal to plus a1 and area2 is equal to plus a2. With the help of these two statements, we can print the values of area1 and area2 for the rectangle 1 and rectangle 2. Now we will move to the execution of a program. Now we had stored the particular program on the desktop. Now first we will compile the program, that is Java C space the program file name, that is area.java. So this will be our compilation. So Java space the class name, the class file will be created after the compilation, Java space area. So after interpretation of the program, we will get the output, that is area 1 is equal to 450 and area 2 will equal to 2000. So this will be only possible with the help of applications of classes, objects and methods. Now, after that, these are the references. Thank you.